Good evening, and welcome to the 76th edition of the Wildcat Sports Network. I'm Connor Jenkins. On tonight's show, we recap the matchup against Arkansas powerhouse North Little Rock. Catch up with Coach Wood about the upcoming matchup against Fort Smith Northside. Special guest Maddux McCrackin will join us in the studio to talk about the Wildcats' hot start to the conference play and what to expect throughout the season. We've got a pretty big show tonight, so no time to waste. It's Friday, September 17th, 2021, and the Wildcat Sports Network starts right now. Joining us now in the studio to kick things off is Coach Wood. Coach, thanks for joining us. Coach, 2 weeks ago you took on the charging Wildcats. You went into the half only down by three. You scored 21 points in the first half. You came out in the second half and just got shut out. Were you kind of gassed, or what do you think led to that second half?
No, I think, you know, we had a really good first half, and but we left some opportunities on the field. And so, you know, we had a couple turnovers that led to points. And so when you get in a situation where you're playing someone as good as a North Little Rock, you've got to go in and execute, and you got to take advantage. And I think, you know, they went in at halftime, and they just settled themselves down. We're going to run the ball and see if we can control the run game. They were able to do that. Biggest difference in the second half, we weren't able to match scores, and they were able to pull away from us. And our guys battled, fought to the bitter end, but it just comes back to still kind of cleaning up some little things. Turnovers is a big deal for us right now, and then just making sure we execute in those critical moments. And so guys are doing a really good job. I've got to do a better job as head coach, making sure we're in position to make those plays and clean up a little bit of those lack of execution plays.
I mean, talking about that, he had three fumbles that game, just one a few yards from the end zone. Mm-hmm. I know you preach a lot about ball security. How do you improve that and address that in practice to kind of improve it for today's game?
Well, one of the things you got to be, it's a fine line, because the more you harp on it, it gets in the players' heads. And then, you know, when they go out there and they play on a Friday night, they don't want to turn the ball over. They don't want to make mistakes. They're giving us everything they have. And so we just kind of continue to focus to work it in practice. We just don't hammer them with it. And just because I don't think that's good for a mindset. And, you know, I trust our guys. And they're going to clean that up. They're going to play better tonight. And, you know, hopefully we'll win that turnover battle.
The second half, the team looked completely different from the first half. Mm-hmm. You ended up losing that game by 30. Do you think just North Little Rock was that good, or is that an accurate depiction of your team, or just didn't play right?
Well, I mean, I think, you know, one, North Little Rock's a good ball club. You're talking about a team that's played for the last four or five state championships. They know how to win, and I think that's evident, them going into Fayetteville last week and winning that game. And what it really showed is the talent of that defense at North Little Rock and where we can be as an offense. I mean, like I said, we had 21 points a half. We had an opportunity for some more scores before the half. Second half, it just really came down to just the lack of execution. When we had to make the play, we just really came up a little bit short on that. Defensively, you know, we got to do a better job of being a little bit more gap sound. We gave them some creases in there. You don't give dynamic players creases, and then they'll make you really pay for it. Again, that goes back to me making sure we're doing all the little things right on the practice field, and in that it carries over into the game, because when it's all said and done, our kids are playing extremely hard. It's just we've got to execute better. I've got to make sure we're doing that on the practice field. So, you know, that's kind of what happened in that third quarter. That's really the difference for third quarter in the first half, is just we didn't answer the scores, and then we couldn't get off the field defensively. And so when that happens, it snowballs on you pretty quickly, especially when you're dealing with a really talented team like North Little Rock.
Coach, thanks for joining us.
Yep.
We'll bring back Coach Wood later to close the show out. In the meantime, if you missed the game, our WCSN team was there to capture the highlights. Take a look.
Wildcats took on North Little Rock charging Wildcats. Very original, am I right? For their second game of non-conference play, let's get to the highlights. Kicking things off, our Wildcats will receive. Number one, Lane Reeder takes it to the 21-yard line, and Wildcat football is underway. Little Rock is going to make the move first as Torrance Moore is going to run this one in, and Little Rock is on the board 6-0. New quarterback Luke Buchanan connects with Landon Anderson, 40-yard pass before being brought down. But what's more impressive is number 12 being brought down by his own teammate. Hey, ouch, pal. Looking to capitalize, Buchanan's going to hand this one to Hudson Brewer with the juke and jive, and he's going to run it in for the touchdown. And Luke Adams says, yay, high five, honey. Still the first quarter, believe it or not. Low snap, Luke Buchanan recovers, hands it to Ethan Fender, who tosses it back to Drew McClendon, our old quarterback buddy, for the dipsy doodle, to pass to Luke Buchanan himself, and he runs it 25 yards before being aggressively pushed out of bounds. Still trying to capitalize, Buchanan hands it off to Brewer, and man, oh man, Coach Wood is going to love this ball security talk come Sunday. That's going to be the first turnover on the night, and unfortunately, the last. North Little Rock driving now, and number four, Malachi Gober looks deep and connects with Jaquari Stewart, 45-yard touchdown pass. We caught up to Braxton Scott after the game to ask him what happened. He said, and I quote, he's just too darn fast. HAR-BER looking to recover now. Luke Buchanan tosses it to Drew McClendon for the 60-yard touchdown pass. Redemption! Feels so good. Side note, why are Drew McClendon's legs so long? Still the first quarter, 14-14. HAR-BER kicks it off, and number one, John Lewis, skirts by Jackson Lanning, dodges Ishmael Bunglick, tiptoes around Justin Gomez before finally being sniped by Sutton Reed. Special teams! All of that, and North Little Rock wasn't able to score. HAR-BER's turn now. Snap to Luke Buchanan. He's going to take it himself, but number six gets his big old bear paw on the ball, and that is the second fumble of the night. Second quarter action now. Buchanan's going to look to keep it himself. Runs it up the middle. He sees the light at the end of the tunnel. Freedom! Close! Brought down by number 13 at the 5-yard line, which sets them up for the perfect opportunity to score. Luke Buchanan connects with Luke Adams. That is a touchdown, my friends. We're going to Party City. I love Party City because they give you the tools to succeed. Little Rock looking to return the favor. Number 9, Davian Vason with the 7-yard boot, scoot, and boogie, and he'll walk into the end zone. Little Rock leads 24-21. HAR-BER looking to close out the first half. They have the opportunity to go ahead. Buchanan hands it off to Huddy B. Go, Huddy B. Sam loves you. And that is not what Sam wants as Huddy B fumbles in at the goal line. That is the third fumble of the night. Huddy B. Third quarter action now. Spoiler alert, the second half was all Little Rock. Here's a prime example. Old Gober completes this 30-yard pass. He's going to tiptoe through the tulips all the way to the end zone. Here's one of the only two highlights HAR-BER had the second half. Buchanan looks to the McClendon for this 30-yard completion, and unfortunately, they could not make anything of it. Little Rock driving now. Gober is going to give this one off to Moore. He wants more football! He's like a phantom. Nobody can touch him. He's going to force Gump this one all the way into the locker room. Little Rock up a baker's dozen. Little Rock keeps putting damage on the board as Gober connects with Lewis for a 35-yard pass. Number 19 says, you did it, friend. Look at this dance. Late fourth quarter, we can say HAR-BER never gave up. Buchanan connects with Peyton McKee, who dives into the end zone, fumbles it, but it's recovered by Blige Cook. So technically, we won't count that as a fumble. HAR-BER's on the board again, but it's not enough as Little Rock puts this one away 58-28. Up next, HAR-BER takes on Northside at home. Be sure to bring your friends, bring your family, and bring yourself to this epic matchup as the Wildcats take down the mighty Grizzlies. We'll see you there. For WCSN, I'm Nick Luttrell.
The Wildcats fell short 58-28 against the charging Wildcats. Tonight, they look for redemption as they take on another Arkansas football powerhouse, Fort Smith Northside. WCSN will be there to bring you all live event coverage. Let's take a quick commercial break to hear from a few of our sponsors that make this show possible. But don't go anywhere. We have Hudson Brewer standing by when we come back. Don't change the channel. The Wildcat Sports Network. We'll be right back.
Presented by McLarty Daniel.
Come
see the largest pre-owned inventory in Northwest Arkansas.
Whatever you're looking for, you'll find it in McClarty Daniel Country. With 800 pre-owned vehicles at six giant locations in Bentonville and Springdale, there's something for everyone. Plus,
at McClarty Daniel, you're protected.
Drive worry-free for 7 years or 200,000 miles with the MD Pre-Owned Advantage. And when it's time to sell your car, we're ready to buy it, even if you don't buy from us. Have you visited McClarty Daniel Country yet?
Visit us online at McClartyDaniel.com.
Hometown. That word still means something here. It means we're neighbors. We do the right thing. We care about your family. And you deserve the very best every time you walk in the front door. Harps. Hometown Fresh.
Our 30 minutes or less ER service pledge means faster care. And because we're full-service hospitals, a lot more care if you need it. Less waiting, faster care. At Northwest Health System, Bentonville and Springdale.
Catering provided by Slim Chickens.
Nothing says game day like good friends and great food. And at Slim Chickens, we know great food. From our 100% all-natural chicken dinners, fresh-made wings served with house sauces, to delicious chicken sandwiches, crisp salads, southern sides, and desserts you just can't get anywhere else. At Slim's, we have the food you love, made fresh for the people you care about. Dine in, drive through, or order online. Slim Chickens. Fresh, delicious chicken.
When you choose First Security, banking is just the beginning. Here, we take care of each other, making the community we all share even stronger. So people in Arkansas can build a life, buy a home, run a business, and more. Strength in numbers and neighbors. It's another way First Security helps Arkansas bank better. And it's why you should call on us today. First Security. Bank better.
On the counter, find a hole. Garrett inside the five. Touchdown, Springdale. Good!
Wide open, Trey Smith, touchdown, HAR-BER Wildcats!
When I walk through the halls of my high school, I see the constant pressure to be a doctor, or go into business, or pursue athletics. What if there was an opportunity to be something more? Skills USA offers you an opportunity to explore careers that matter. Careers that we need now. Hands-on trade skills like electrical engineering, construction manufacturing, architectural drafting, and even television productions. With Skills USA, you can gain these essential skills that allow you to bridge the gap from education to careers right out of high school. Skills USA, champions at work.
Welcome back, and joining us now in the studio is Hudson Brewer. Hudson, let's talk North Little Rock. The Wildcats fell short 58-28. What were some key takeaways from that game that you look to kind of fix in these practices and go into the next one?
Well, I think in the first half we came out pretty strong, but once we went into that second half, the big thing that really killed us that game was ball security. And I know it's going to be a good fix for us this week.
Mm-hmm. Kind of going off what you went. And in the first half, you were down by three. You did a really good job kind of handling it. What do you think happened in the second half where it just kind of went downhill from there?
I think we just came out and beat ourselves. We weren't playing like real HAR-BER football.
Moving forward tonight on Portsmouth North side, what's some like, they have a really good history of playing great. They have really good football history. What's the mindset going into that game?
I think that we need to come out and play as hard as we can. And I think that we're going to have a great atmosphere at home, and it's going to bring a lot of confidence to our team.
Talking about that, this is one of your only four home games this year. Mm-hmm. That's pretty tough to do. What does that kind of mean to you to be at home with a ton of fans and How do you think that'll help you walk away with a win?
I think it'll help a lot, especially with our student section. It's going to help. And we really need this win because it's our last non-conference game.
You've seen the film from Northside now. Kind of what's to expect from them on the defensive side?
Well, they're pretty fast off the edge, so I think we're going to have to shoot it up the middle a little bit or maybe even throw it up over them.
Hudson, thanks for joining us and good luck tonight. Hudson is a two-year starter for the Wildcats and a huge impact on and off the field. But one of the other players that is paving the way for the Wildcats' success is Logan Essex. I went behind the scenes to get the inside story on just how important his role is on the road to these years to state title. Take a look.
As the Wildcats start their season with two monumental games with McKinney, Texas and North Little Rock, one of the seniors leading the way is Logan Essex. Tonight, they head to North Little Rock, and his presence is more important on and off the field than ever.
I'd say my impact is just to be a leader and just that the voice out there, just getting everyone going and just being hardworking, a hardworking dude, and showing everyone what, you know, what it looks like to work hard and you know, just being a leader through my actions.
Logan Essex stands at 6'2", 230, and has the strength and speed necessary to make the most of his new position. This defense is better than ever and ready to make a run at the state title.
Man, it's awesome. As a linebacker, Logan's job is to make sure that those big dudes like Logan don't come up and hit me and Ross, and he's really good about being a big body and making sure that they just don't work up to us, and he's really good at what he does.
This wide receiver turned defensive end has already made an impact on the D-line, allowing for the shift of personnel for both the D-line and linebacker corps.
Well, I think it makes everybody around him better, number one, like I said. And it, you know, he's a force out there. He's a big kid. He plays hard. His get-off is good. And, you know, he gives offensive lines trouble.
I saw that I could help the team more as a defensive end and not necessarily as a wide receiver. You know, we have a lot of talent at the wide receiver position with Peyton and Ethan and all them. And I saw that I would impact the team in a better way at defensive end.
Every senior has an impact on their team no matter what the role is. Logan Essex embodies HAR-BER's mentality of dedication and hard work, and he leads his teammates down the exact same path. And that leadership and hard work will help us tonight as we head to the Rock. For WCSN, I'm Connor Jenkins.
Logan Essex is number 97 on the field, and you can see him every Friday night on the Wildcat Sports Network. Speaking of WCSN, we also cover sports content on our social media pages as well. Our HAR-BER cross country team has a meet on Tuesday at the University of Ozarks, and our HAR-BER tennis team plays Thursday at Fayetteville. Be sure to follow us on all social media to keep up to date. Right now, we're going to take a quick commercial break. When we come back, we'll catch up with defensive specialist Maddux McCrackin. Don't go anywhere. The Wildcat Sports Network will be right back.
Presented by McLarty Daniel.
If you want fast, easy, and affordable service, visit McLarty Daniel.
Keep your vehicle running like new in our state-of-the-art service facilities. We know your time is valuable. Our factory-certified technicians with decades of experience will get you in and out and back on the road quickly. We service all makes and models at our six convenient locations in Bentonville and Springdale, open 6 days a week.
Visit McLartyDaniel.com to schedule your service appointment today.
Catering provided by Slim Chickens.
Try the 3-and-3 meal at Slim Chickens. Three hand-breaded chicken tenders paired with three perfectly fried wings, shaken in your choice of house flavors. Served with fries, Texas toast, and a medium drink. Slim Chickens. Fresh, delicious chicken.
Accidents are never planned. But no matter how small, every emergency that involves a child is a big deal. It's everything. That's why we're here. Arkansas Children's Northwest offers the only pediatric emergency room in Northwest Arkansas, with fast access, pediatric experts, and kid-sized care. Peace of mind when you need it most.
Ballpark Franks got their start in 1957, right here in the ballpark. And with the taste of 100% Angus beef passed down from one generation to the next, they soon became a tradition everywhere, bringing on the feeling of summer in every bite. Ballpark Franks, bring on summer.
Experience everything Springdale has to offer. Visit ExploreSpringdale.com or download the new Explore Springdale app. It's the best place to discover all there is to do and see in Springdale. We'll help you explore our many eateries and attractions and introduce you to our shopping, arts, parks, and trails. You'll also find links to our great hotels and meeting venues. Download the new Explore Springdale app or visit ExploreSpringdale.com to begin your Springdale adventure.
Claymax at the NWA, it's just an easy, customer-centered experience. Right now is probably the easiest time that I've ever seen to achieve financing for people on maybe even a more expensive vehicle or more accommodating vehicle for their family. I've got the best inventory, I would say, in the state, and my people are not only experienced in the car business, but they're experienced in the people business. Whether you just check us out online or you check us out in person, we want you to visit us. Claymax at the NWA and ClaymaxTheNWA.com.
When you bank with First Security, you're choosing real support for you and for our home state. So friends, families, and fellow Arkansans find better solutions together. It's another way First Security helps Arkansas bank better. And it's why you should call on us today. First Security, bank better.
For WCSN, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
No, you gotta own it. You gotta be like, for WCSN, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
For WCSN, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
No, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
Okay, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
Better.
Okay, yeah, but don't you think I should add like some?
Red, yellow card.
Is she gonna be okay?
Yeah, they always do this.
Okay, so you said, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
Yeah, just
no. But don't you think that I should add something like, that's the way the cookie crumbles, or, ooh, okay, good one. I could say something like,
no, just one more time.
Okay, for WCSN, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
Much better.
Welcome back, Wildcats. Joining us in the studio now is senior volleyball defensive specialist, Maddux McCrackin. Maddux, you guys started off the season on fire. I like to call it the sweepstakes. You sweep your first four conference games. What was your mentality coming into this season, and how do you look to continue that success?
So I think that we've kind of known, like, through the past, like, seasons that we've had a good team, and we knew, like, our senior year, like, that was our year. Like, we want to make it as, like, best as it can be. And so, like, our mentality going in is, like, we know we have the skill, but it's really just about building those relationships on and off the court that are going to, like, push us to success this year, and not getting, like, too confident. Like, you want to have, like, a healthy balance, you know, like, not get too cocky about anything. About, like you said, like, we won our first four, but we're not going to let that, like, change anything we're doing for the second half of conference or our later games, because we know, like, it's important to stay, like, dialed in. And so that's kind of what we're using.
I know it's still a little bit ways out, but Fayetteville, one of the major threats still left on the table. How big is that game to you guys?
Fayetteville's a great team. They've always been one of our, like, biggest rivals. And so that game is very big for us, especially, like, losing to them last year in the semifinals of the state tournament. Like, it was pretty heartbreaking, you know, like, that's the end of your season and knowing all that. And so we really try to use, like, that as motivation. Like, hey, we're going to work harder. We're going to go out and give it everything we got. And so, like, looking to that game, it's hard not to, like, just automatically want to look towards that game. Like, we know we have games in between, but that's definitely going to be one of our biggest ones. We really want, like, Blue Crew to show up, because that's going to be, like, such a great, like, atmosphere, like, having all those people there and, like, what's on the line and stuff. So
you're a two-sport athlete. You also play on the Lady Wildcats basketball team. How do you think those sports blend together to kind of make you a more competitive athlete?
They definitely blend. Like, I would say the things on the volleyball court make me a 10 times the basketball player I am, and the things on the basketball court make me such better volleyball player, just because I'm in shape. And then also, like, it's both on and off the court, because I'm, like, have to learn how to communicate with different people, because you have two completely different sports, and so you have to know, like, hey, this works for volleyball, this works for basketball. So, like, it's the blending and, like, knowing what's going to work best for that team. And so it just makes me all around a better, like, athlete, I think. And it makes me a better leader, because I'm able to be so, like, different and understand different perspectives. So
we have a lot of seniors this year, 14 seniors, one junior. So we might not get to talk to you again. What is your plans kind of after high school, or do you look to pursue this after in the collegiate level?
So my plans, I plan for this to be my last volleyball season, and I want to go to UCA and pursue dental hygiene. And so that's why, like, this year, playing with my best friends that I've played since some of them elementary school, some of them junior high, and then just that I've known, like, all my life, we want to make this, like, our best season yet. And just, like, that's how we want to leave our mark here at HAR-BER. And if it's my last time on the court, like, I want to know that it's that I'm making it the best I can for my team and then for HAR-BER's sake. So.
Maddux, thanks for joining us and good luck this season.
Thank you.
You can find Maddux sporting number 12 every Tuesday and Thursday, as well as the rest of the senior Wildcat volleyball team. This past week, we had the time to go courtside to catch up with senior libero Josie McCroskey and just show how she is getting the tone for the rest of the season. Here's the story.
Coming off a great start to the season, being 11-0 and ranked first in the conference, the Lady Wildcats look to continue this success with the help of star libero, Josie McCroskey.
Josie McCroskey.
I feel like my impact on this team is just that I bring, like, a great leadership to the team, and I'm very comfortable with every player on our team. And so it just makes everybody on the court, as a libero, like, I'm supposed to be the leader. And so everybody's just comfortable with me and can come to me about anything.
The libero spot comes with its leadership role, and Josie embraces that role by being a team captain and a positive voice on and off the court.
I think everybody can agree that she's always somebody that will be there for you no matter what. Like, when we're on the court and one of us is freaking out, like, I know I always look to Josie, and she's right there, like, helping me, like, with what to do or, like how to fix my mistake. And so she always calms me down if I'm ever, like, freaking out about anything, and that's, like, in life too.
While Josie McCroskey's leadership at the libero spot is obvious, her success at that spot is also very evident. Josie averages 3.7 digs per game and 2.6 assists per game, as well as making her not only a successful leader, but a dominant player.
Josie McCroskey has made such an impact on HAR-BER volleyball. Her legacy will stay with us forever. She's obviously an amazing volleyball player, but I'm just gonna miss seeing her face every day in the gym. She brings a smiling face, she brings great energy, she's a great person, she leads people with grace, and she loves her teammates well. So aside from all the volleyball aspect, I'm just gonna miss seeing her and having her as a human being in our gym. But obviously her volleyball will be very missed on the court as well.
Josie McCroskey looks to continue playing volleyball after at the collegiate level with multiple D2 offers. She leads the HAR-BER Wildcats in digs with 100 digs on the season. There is no shortage of talent nor leadership when it comes to Josie McCroskey, and she looks to bring that to this team every single day. For WCSN, I'm Connor Jenkins.
Our Lady Wildcats start the season off 5-0, heading into the final stretch of the first half of conference play next week. Next Thursday, the Lady Wildcats take on Fayetteville at Fayetteville. Be sure to come out and support. This will be a monumental matchup, but before that, let's take another quick commercial break. But when we come back, Malachi Kramer is in the studio. Don't go anywhere. You're watching the Wildcat Sports Network.
Going outside. It's been a great season for HAR-BER. Great season.
What is pain? What is pain to you? Do you understand? Do you even know what pain is? Stop running from it. Embrace the pain that you're going to feel when you're trying to do something great. With greatness comes pain. Let's change what follows our I am. I am successful. I am powerful. I am great.
Wow.
I am amazing. Woo! You have to learn to embrace that pain. You have to learn to dig deep when you feel that pain in your heart. When you're feeling pain, dig a little bit deeper. On the other side of pain is greatness. How bad do you want to be great?
Ozarks Go from Ozarks Electric Cooperative is leading the fiber revolution. Connecting the divide with high-speed broadband access to close that gap. From cloud to cloud, post to post. From downtown to way out of town. To connect our customers to a world of blazing speed and access to absolutely everywhere. It's our customers connected and energized with Ozarks Go.
During the Great Depression, nothing came easy. But with just 5 cents, an old truck, and a load of hay, John Tyson and his family found a way to deliver quality chicken to other hardworking people. Today, Tyson continues to find new ways to help put a chicken in every pot. Because people deserve farm-raised chicken of the highest quality. At Tyson, we remain committed to this simple promise, to always keep it real, to always keep it Tyson.
Hey, Northwest Arkansas, Lara here at Sam's Furniture. If you're looking for new furniture, we have over 170,000 square feet selection at everyday low prices and same day delivery available. But the best part is that we love to serve our community. So when you buy at Sam's, part of your purchase goes to support one of the many amazing organizations that we have been blessed to partner with. Serving others, especially those in need, is our culture here, and we hope that you'll be a part of that too. Arkansas's largest furniture destination, get it at Sam's.
Hello, my name is Donald Tucker. I'm the owner and award-winning pitmaster of bbqfunding.com. I'm here today to tell you we are the company that runs the last fundraiser you will ever need. For 15 years, I have competed across the country in competitions like Bikes, Blues, and Barbecue, as well as the American Royal. And now we want to use our talents to bring you competition quality, fully cooked, slow hickory smoke barbecue to meet all your fundraising needs. Through bbqfunding.com, we can show you how to raise all the money your team, organization, even your entire school. And what if I told you it only takes 1 minute a day? When was the last time you didn't have to worry about how you were gonna pay for the things you needed, let alone the things you wanted? bbqfunding.com can deliver that for you. You don't have to carry around an order form, collect any money, handle any products, or go door to door. That's right, this fundraiser is also pandemic safe. Our team does all the work for you, and all you have to do is give us 1 minute a day. I want to personally thank each and every one of you for the opportunity to help continue to not only serve you, but also your community. My passion is serving others, and I'm dedicated to you and investing in your future. So take the leap and join the movement that is BBQ Funding.
At Northwest Health, you can check in online for urgent care and ER visits. This simple step lets you pick a time that's convenient and saves your spot in line before you arrive. It's our new approach to the waiting room. Visit mynorthwestanycare.com.
Hey, Nick, catch. Welcome back, and joining us now is senior Malachi Kramer. Kai, North Little Rock was a difficult second half. He had a really good first half, but just a tough loss in the second. What were some key takeaways from that game?
I think some of the key takeaways would be ball security. That's a big one for us. And then wrapping up on tackles.
What has the team been focusing on leading into this Northside game to kind of fix from that game and going into Northside?
So not getting beat deep, that hurt us a lot. Ball security, like I said, we've been doing a lot more drills, working on that. That's about it.
Kind of what are those drills like? Can you give us a little more detail on that?
Yeah, so we do, there's three different drills we do. So we do stumble bump, which is two guys are trying to take the ball away from the offensive guy. And then we do two tackling circuit drills that are good.
You guys started the season with a 12-hour round trip to McKinney, Texas, a 6-hour round trip to North Little Rock. You finally get a much-needed home game. What does that mean to you to finally be at home?
Yeah, the home game, having the band, the student section, everyone there. Hopefully a big crowd. That'll be really good, hearing all the fans and everyone there to support us.
What can we expect tonight from the game?
Tonight, it should be a really good game on the defensive side of the ball. A lot of heavy packages, so a lot of downhill run fits.
Okay, thanks for joining us and good luck tonight.
Thank you.
Let's take another quick commercial break, but stay tuned. Coming up next, we bring you the story of our infamous Blue Crew and the impact they are leaving off the court. Don't change the channel. WCSN will be right back.
Presented by McLarty Daniel.
Come see the largest pre-owned inventory in Northwest Arkansas.
Whatever you're looking for, you'll find it in McClarty Daniel Country. With 800 pre-owned vehicles at six giant locations in Bentonville and Springdale, there's something for everyone. Plus,
at McClarty Daniel, you're protected.
Drive worry-free for 7 years or 200,000 miles with the MD Pre-Owned Advantage. And when it's time to sell your car, we're ready to buy it, even if you don't buy from us. Have you visited McClarty Daniel Country yet?
Visit us online at McClartyDaniel.com.
When accidents happen, our 30 minutes or less ER service pledge can mean less waiting and faster care. The 30 minutes or less ER service pledge at Northwest Health System Bentonville and Springdale.
When I walk through the halls of my high school, I see the constant pressure to be a doctor or go into business or pursue athletics. What if there was an opportunity to be something more? SkillsUSA offers you an opportunity to explore careers that matter, careers that we need now. Hands-on trade skills like electrical engineering, construction manufacturing, architectural drafting, and even television productions. With SkillsUSA, you can gain these essential skills that allow you to bridge the gap from education to careers right out of high school. SkillsUSA, champions at work.
Hey man, you got a light?
Yeah, we can get to that. Do you know the average American spends about $2,000 a year on tobacco products, which typically translates into about $200 a month? All on something that makes you 30 times more likely to die from lung cancer. Knowing that, saying you're burning through your money is an understatement. 31 cents is the cost of a cigarette. 31 cents, big tobacco just bought your future. Don't want that light?
Nah, man, I'm good.
For more information, visit projectpreventar.com.
At Northwest Health, we've made it easier to schedule a doctor's appointment. Online scheduling for our primary care physicians lets you make an appointment at any time from anywhere. It's the new way to book your next visit. MyNorthwestAnyCare.com.
On the counter, find a hole, Garrett inside the five, touchdown Springdale. Good!
Wide open placement, touchdown HAR-BER Wildcats!
Welcome back, Wildcats. Now at the Wildcat Sports Network, we talk all things sports. In our program history, we have covered football, volleyball, basketball, soccer, wrestling, golf, tennis, track, the list goes on and on. But one of the groups recognized the least that makes all of these events continue to excel is our HAR-BER Blue Crew. These fans get together with one common goal, support athletics in every event. Our team went behind the scenes to bring you this story. Take a look.
The biggest thing to any sports team is energy in their environment. Here at HAR-BER High School, we take these things to a whole new level with the help of the Blue Crew.
I think it's so unique to see that big of a crowd starting at our JV match, because typically these kind of fans come for the varsity match, but this group of Blue Crew comes for the JV match, they hype the JV up, and then they roll into varsity too. The energy and the excitement that they bring to the match really, I think, is it puts a lot of pressure on the opposing team, but then also gives our girls a lot of energy, and it's really fun to perform and play in front of a group like that. So Blue Crew has been absolutely amazing.
The Blue Crew is a student-assembled group that meets on club days and various other times to come up with numerous themes. The leaders of this group are several dedicated and Wildcat proud seniors.
We just want to bring a fun environment, especially with the past couple years being like COVID years, and we just want it to be a fun thing to go to a volleyball game or a football game or basketball or whatever, baseball, anything. Even like drama plays and all that. So just to support our classmates and do our thing.
Against a rivalry team, I think that their energy was high and it brought a lot of energy to us. And I feel like having Blue Crew here helped us get our victory.
There is always a need for school spirit. While Blue Crew starts out exclusively for seniors, it is available to all grades to bring the Wildcat pride.
To get into Blue Crew, you just sign up as a senior and try to get yourself in into the club or whatever. But as a underclassman or a junior, you need to be recommended. So just come to the games, have a lot of fun, be loud, be exciting, and then you'll be recommended into the Blue Crew.
From volleyball to basketball to football, the HAR-BER Blue Crew is there when you need it the most. Getting students together for this is no easy task, but the HAR-BER Blue Crew is there and ready to bring the energy. For WCSN, I'm Connor Jenkins.
Want to be a part of Blue Crew? See Dr. Greet for more information. Don't forget, this group of students gets together to ensure there's always a student fan base at every athletic event, something that definitely doesn't go unnoticed. One last quick commercial break, but buckle up. When we come back, Coach Wood is back in the studio to help break down Northside. Wildcat Sports Network, we'll be right back.
At America's Car Mart, our purpose is providing customers peace of mind with quality vehicles to keep you on the road. And right now, we're kicking off 2021 with a huge sale, the New Year's sale. Drive away today for as low as $199 down on select vehicles. Ask about the New Year's sale or start your approval online right now. No matter where you are on your car buying journey, we're here for you, keeping you on the road. America's Car Mart.
Our 30 minutes or less ER service pledge means you'll find less waiting where it matters most. Faster care in the emergency room. The 30 minutes or less ER service pledge at Northwest Health System, Bentonville, and Springdale.
Ozarks Go from Ozarks Electric Cooperative is leading the fiber revolution, connecting the divide with high-speed broadband access to close that gap. From cloud to cloud, post to post, from downtown to way out of town, to connect our customers to a world of blazing speed and access to absolutely everywhere. It's our customers connected.
Wellness centers at Springdale Schools. The wellness centers in Springdale are perfect for students and teachers. Teachers can go during their planning period, and parents don't have to miss work for students to receive medical care. Offering sports physicals, kindergarten physicals, vaccinations, well child checks, acute care, and more. Wellness centers are located at a school near you. Wellness centers and Springdale Schools, we are your medical home.
So, Shane Matthews, his lightning fast speed.
No. He's got explosive speed.
Dude, he's lightning fast.
Shane, would you describe your speed as explosive or lightning fast?
What?
Dude, I'm telling you, he's fast, explosive. Dude.
Lightning fast.
What's that? Lightning fast.
Lightning fast.
Yeah.
Welcome back, and here to help us close the show out is Coach Wood. Coach, two big away games to start off your season. You come back home for the first time, you get your home game. What's the importance of having that home game and that environment tonight?
Well, I mean, the biggest thing, it's middle of September and we're finally playing at home. And we like being at home. We with our band and our student section and our fan base. It's always a fun atmosphere. And so, you know, our guys are ready to be in the Navy jerseys and go out and play a football game against a really good Northside team.
They're off to a really good start this year. They beat Greenwood and Southside. What can you expect from tonight's game?
Well, I think they're a team that runs the ball really well. They've got two really dynamic tailbacks that go downhill. They're hard to bring down. They're probably going to get in a too tight set a little bit on us and see how we match up against that to stop our run. So you stop the run, you got a chance. And then offensively, they're really aggressive, kind of run a hybrid of a bare front and play really good man. They're cover three over the top of that with edge pressure and try to get you in matchups. So it's a well-coached team that's playing good football right now, and we both want to set the stage as we go into conference play next week.
Coach, as always, what's kind of the game plan to secure that win tonight?
Well, the biggest thing tonight, like defensively, it's maintaining that running game. You know, they were able to be effective against Greenwood. We've got to stop the run. We've got to get them in passing downs and then prevent the big plays. Offensively, let's get the run game going as well because, you know, a lot of teams, you win stopping the run, you win running the ball. So offensively, got to do that. And, of course, what we've harped on the last couple of weeks, can't turn the ball over against a good ball club or you're going to dig a hole you can't get out of.
Coach, thanks for joining us again and good luck tonight. That's going to do it for us tonight. On behalf of Superintendent Dr. Jared Cleveland, Athletic Director Wayne Stellick, I'm Connor Jenkins. Up next is kickoff. We'll see you next time.
If you'll have faith tonight, you'll stay focused on the task, and you're willing to get out of the boat and walk on water, we're going to be just fine. And you can't have any doubts. Can't sit in the boat and criticize. I want a bunch of guys that will walk on water.
Outside, outside.
Looking at the stars, staring with my mouth wide. I ain't letting nobody stop me this time. With every single level that I reach and I climb, they ask, are you from outside, outside? Everything around me I create with my mind. Working too hard, I don't want no downtime. Put my team on, they gon' shine when I shine. We can take this outside, outside.
Intercepted. Cuts back on his inside.
It's off the foot race, so you're not going to catch him. Five.
Touchdown. Harbor Wildcats to the 20, to the 10. What a play. Yeah, we can take this. You are just not on my level. You are just not on my level. You are just not on my level. You are just not on my level.
By the Wildcats.